Okay, today we are going to discuss the work power energy. It's a very, very important topic for objective orientation in advance and mains also. Not only in advance and mains, in different deemed universities like WIT, okay, Amrita, for those exams also it's very, very important. Okay, now first we have to discuss what is the work done. So first we have to discuss work. Suppose on the floor, suppose it is a smooth floor. Here there is a block of mass M is kept. Here it is a block of mass M. Okay. Then by applying the here on the block, at this point some force is applied like this. F force is applied with certain inclination so that the force, direction of action of the force makes an angle theta with horizontal. Because you pull the block in this direction by applying pulling force, this one. That means by means of a rope, it is pulled like this. Okay, then even the block is pulled in this direction, the block will displace along horizontal direction on the floor. No, that's why displacement is along this direction. Displacement is along this direction, whereas the applied force is along this direction. That means in this case, displacement and applied force both are in different directions. In this case, how we can calculate the work done? Here, this is the point of application of the force, no? So, because of applied force on a body, if the point of application of the force, point of application of the force on a body means this one, that displaces along the direction of the applied force, then we can say the work is said to be done on the block by the force. If the point of application of the force on a body displaces along the direction of the applied force, then we can say work is done by the applied force on the body or on the block. Okay, how we can find this work done? General formula for work done is work W is equal to force acts on a body into displacement of the body along the direction of applied force. Displacement along applied force. Applied force or displacement of the body into force along the direction of displacement. Anyone we can write along the direction of displacement. So this is a general formula for work done. Okay, therefore work done W is equal to, you see, displacement S into force along the direction of applied displacement means the force component along the direction of displacement means in this direction, what is the force component? F cos theta. Here, this component is F sin theta. Okay. Now, what is the force component along the direction of displacement means F cos theta only no? F cos theta. Therefore, this is equal to Fs cos theta, we can write. This is equal to F is a vector quantity, displacement is also a vector quantity. And theta is the angle between F and S, no? That's why in vector form, we can write this as F bar dot S bar. Sometimes we will be given displacement vector in vector form and force also in vector form. In that case, to obtain the work done, just we have to do the dot product between force and displacement. That gives work done. So this is the general formula for work done. In this case, what is the normal reaction? Here, if the mass of the body is M, then weight of the body is Mg. That always acts vertically downwards direction. So in this case, what is the normal reaction? Tell me. In this case, what is the normal reaction? In this case, what is the normal reaction? What is the normal reaction? Mg. Minus, very good. Here, along the block, on the block along vertical direction, weight Mg acts downwards direction, F sine theta acts in upward direction. Definitely, as they ask the normal reaction here, definitely the body would be in contact with the floor. That's why Mg must be greater than F sine theta. So normal reaction means that always acts upward direction. Normal reaction, N is the upward direction. It is perpendicular to the plane of contact, but acts on the upper body in this case, in this diagram. Because weight pushes the body downwards. Weight pushes the body. And due to this, the block pushes the floor in downwards direction. So floor exert the reaction force on the body in upward direction. That is the normal reaction. So in this case, normal reaction is equal to net force acts on the block along vertical direction in downwards direction. That means mz minus f sine theta is the net force acts on the block downwards direction. With this force, the block pushes the floor in downwards direction. The equivalent reaction force exerted by the floor on the block in upward direction, as along vertical direction there is no motion, there is no displacement. That's why n is equal to mz minus f sine theta. It is the normal reaction. So it is the general formula for work done. Is work done a scalar or vector? Is Devang Yadav. Already I told them two times. If you continue to share the video, definitely I will remove from the class. Devang Yadav. What I said, you don't share the video. Teja also. Devang Yadav, Teja, you stop your videos. Are you not able to hear Devang and Teja? Teja, you too. You stop your video. Teja. You stop your video. Okay. So it is the normal reaction acts on the body. Is work done a scalar or vector? Work done is a scalar or vector? No, it is a scalar, because work done is the dot product between two vectors. Is dot product a scalar or vector? Yeah, dot product is a scalar. That's why work done is a scalar quantity. Work is a scalar because it has no direction. Work done is a scalar quantity. Okay, yeah, what is the SI unit of work done? SI unit of work done. Here you see, work done means force into displacement. Okay, force means Newton, displacement means meter. Or this Newton meter is also called as the joule. Newton meter is also called as the joule in SI system. Okay, in CS system, CS unit of work is equal to dyne, and displacement is force is measured in dyne, displacement in centimeter. Or this is also equal to erg, dyne centimeter or erg. That is the CS unit of the work done. Okay. Here, what is the relation between joule and erg? So, one joule is equal to how many erg? Actually, one joule is equal to one Newton meter. We know. One into Newton means 10 to the power of 5 dyne. Okay. Hyphen into meter means 10 square centimeter, because 100 centimeter, no? So 10 to the power of 5, 10 to the power of 2. That means 10 to the power of 7 dyne centimeter. Therefore, 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power of 7 dyne centimeter means erg, no? That's why this is equal to erg. So 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power of 7 erg. This is the relation between joule and erg. It is the relation between joule and erg. So there are different types of units are there. Kilowatt hour, that is also unit of energy, or sometimes it may be used for work also. Kilowatt hour. Okay, whenever we discuss the energy, at the time we will discuss. Here it is the relation between joule and erg. Next, what is the dimension formula of work done? Dimensional formula of work W is equal to, in square brackets you write, that means dimensional formula of work done is equal to, how we can write here, work done means force into displacement, we can write in general. Okay, r cos theta, fs cos theta. Okay, here cos theta is the number, it has no dimension formula, only fs. So dimension formula of work done means dimension formula of f into s. This is equal to dimension formula of force means mlt to prof minus 2, displacement means l. Okay, therefore dimension formula of work done is equal to m into l square t to power of minus 2. Here power, if power is here, power is one only, no? One. So therefore this is the dimension formula of work done. It is the dimension formula of work done. Okay, ml square t to power of minus 2. I think already I said dimension formulas up to work done. Am I right? I said the dimensional formula of work done. Okay. Now, here in different cases, we had to calculate the work done. And what are the types of the work done? There are three types of work done are there. There are three types of work done. Okay. So zero work, positive work, negative work. In this way, there are different types of work done are there. So we have to discuss them first. So we have to discuss the types of work. Okay. Types of work. First one, positive work. Positive work. Positive work. Suppose on the block, if you apply the force on a body along this direction so that it makes an angle theta with the displacement. In this case, whenever theta zero, theta lies between zero and 90 degree. So zero less than or equal to theta less than 90. In this case, theta may be equal to zero or theta greater than zero, but less than 90. In such case, here in the formula for work done, W is equal to Fs cos theta. No, Fs cos theta. Okay, here for that means acute angle. Here theta is the acute. Okay, therefore, for this acute angle between the force and the displacement, always you will get cos theta positive. That's why in this case, work done is said to be positive. Okay. So whenever the angle between force and displacement is the acute angle, then work done is acute. Then the work done is said to be positive work. What is the example for a positive work? Okay. Here, in this case, what is the maximum work? In this case, in positive work done, what is the maximum work done? When theta is equal to 0 degree, then cos 0, that is equal to 1, which is maximum. So for the given force, what is the maximum work done means? Therefore, work maximum is equal to Fs into cos 0 1. That's why Fs. This is the formula for maximum work done. Okay, it is the formula for maximum work done. Next, here, what is the example for this positive work? Suppose one body, whenever the body is released from certain height, when a body having mass m is released from certain height, then here you see the weight of the body mz acts vertically downwards direction. Due to that, the body displaces through a distance, say s. In this case, the force acts on the body, F is equal to mz, that is downwards direction, and the displacement also in the same direction, downwards direction only. In this case, here it is a gravitational force. Now, when you release the body here, because of gravity, the body comes down. Suppose whenever the body has displacement, yes, after some time, what is the work done by gravity in this time? That is a question they asked. So work done by gravity, that is represented by Wg, or work done by gravity Wg is equal to, according to this formula, Fs cos theta. Fs cos theta. This is equal to, suppose after some time, this body reaches the ground so that it has a displacement equal to h. That means a body is dropped from a height h. Then before reaches the ground, what is the work done by gravity? That is the question they asked. So F means mg, displacement s is equal to h into cos. What is the theta means? That is the angle between the force and displacement. No? You see, whenever the body comes down because of gravity, force acts on the body, which is equal to gravitational force mg, acts downwards direction. And a displacement also in downwards direction. Okay, that's why both are in the same direction. Hence, angle between force and displacement is zero. That's why you write zero. Therefore, work done by gravity in this case is equal to mz into h, since cos zero is equal to one. So this is the work done by gravity. We got positive sign, no? That's why work done by gravity here is positive. Okay. So this is one type of work done. Next, B. Zero work. Zero work. When theta is equal to 90 degree, that means whenever the force acts on a body is perpendicular to the displacement, in such case work done is zero. Suppose here you see force acts on a body is in this direction, force acts on a body is along vertical direction. You take, suppose this is one body, it is one body. Okay, so here on the smooth surface the body is kept like this, it is a smooth surface. The displacement of the body is in this direction, whereas the force acts on the body is in upward direction. Of course, normally action acts on the body in upward direction and weight mg acts in downward direction. In this case, what is the work done by gravity? Work done by gravity is equal to weight mg into displacement s into angle cos of angle between weight and the displacement, that is 90, cos 90, that is called zero, no? That means work done by gravity on the block here is zero. That means whenever the block is moving horizontally, in such case, as the gravity always acts vertically downwards direction, the angle between force and this gravitational force and displacement is 90. That's why work done is zero here. That means even best example, a porter carrying the luggage on his head in railway stations, porter is there, no? So here the porter carries the luggage on his head. He kept a huge luggage and he is travel along horizontal direction. Then what is the work done by gravity of the weight on him? Gravity of the weight means we can say zero work. Even though he carries the very huge luggage, very large luggage, more weight along horizontal direction, then what is the work done by gravity means we can say work done by gravity here is zero. Because gravitational force acts vertically downwards direction and the displacement of the luggage is along horizontal direction. That's why due to gravity no work is done. But by means of head, between the head and this block, because of friction, he pushes the block in luggage in forward direction by means of head. That's why because of that only this will travel in forward direction. But in this case, work done by gravity is zero. Okay. Next, here no work is done. Next one example here, what is the work done by normal reaction? Work done by normal reaction is Wn. That is equal to work done by normal reaction is equal to normal reaction n into displacement s into cos angle between normal reaction and displacement, that is 90. Here it is 90, no? Therefore 90, cos 90 is zero. That's why in this case work done by normal reaction is also zero. Okay, so one more example we have to discuss. Suppose a body having mass m, a body having mass m moving under gravity, moving vertically upwards with a constant velocity in upward direction, with a uniform velocity or constant velocity in upward direction, constant velocity in upward direction like this. A body, by applying the force F, the body is pulled vertically upward direction with a constant velocity. In this case, what is the net work done? In this case, what is the net work done? First of all, what is the force applied on the body to move the body upwards with a constant velocity? First, we have to find. So along vertical direction, what are the forces acts on the body? Along vertical direction, what are the forces acts on the body? Very good, Karthi. Along vertical direction, what is the forces acts on the body? Weight mg acts vertically downwards direction and applied force acts on the body upward direction. Okay. So as the body is moving upwards, net force acts on the body in the upper direction. So F minus mg, that is equal to mass into acceleration. So F minus mg is equal to mass into, what about acceleration? As the body moving upwards with constant velocity, acceleration is zero, no? So zero. Therefore, this is equal to zero. F minus mg is equal to zero means F is equal to mg, no? So by applying force, when the body is made to move with constant velocity upwards, in that case, applied force is equal to weight of the body itself. Now, the force applied on a body along vertical upward direction is known, weight is known. Now, what is the net work done by all these forces whenever the body displaces through certain distance? So, because of this applied force, suppose the body displaces through a distance equal to S is equal to, say, H. In this case, what is the net work done? In this case, what is the work done by applied force? Tell me. Work done by applied force, WF is equal to applied force F into displacement in the direction of applied force is equal to H. F means already we got mg, mg into H. So this is a positive work done, because applied force is in upward direction, displacement also in upward direction only. That's why angle between force and displacement is zero. Cos 0, 1. Whenever cos 0, 1, then work done is equal to F into S only, no? F into displacement here is H. That's why mg, F into H. F means mg into H. Next, work done by weight of the body or work done by gravity is equal to, general formula is Fs cos theta only. Okay, F means weight of the body, that is equal to mg. S means H into cos. What is the angle between displacement and weight? What is the angle between displacement and weight? 180 degree, because displacement is in upward direction, weight is in downward direction. That's why angle between them is 180 degree. 180 degree. Therefore, cos 180 minus 1, no? Minus 1 into mgh means minus mg into h. It is the work done by gravity. So therefore, here, whenever the body displaces in upward direction through a distance h, then in this case, we have calculated all the work done. Therefore, what is the net work done? Net work done. Net work done is equal to work done by gravity plus work done by applied force. Work done by gravity is minus mgh. Work done by applied force is plus mgh. These two cancel. Therefore, net work done in this case is zero. That means even the body is displaced upwards by applying some force, we can say net work done is zero. Net work done on the body is zero. Riding cycle. Riding cycle is whenever the bicycle is riding, then work done is zero means work done by us is there. Work done by centripetal force, that is zero. Not in all cases. Okay. Black Panther. Force applied. No. Because of our pelling, the frictional force acts on them. Because of frictional force, some work is done. Definitely. Displacement is there. No. When you ride the bicycle, it is moving in forward direction. No? Whenever the bicycle is riding, then it is moving in forward direction on the road. That's why some work is said to be done there. Work done by weight of the bicycle is zero. Okay. Right. Now, net work done is equal to here, zero. So this is the example for zero work. Next, negative work. Already here, negative work we got. Work done by weight of the body is equal to minus mgh we got now. Work done by weight of the body is equal to minus mgh. That is the net negative work done. Okay. Of course, we'll discuss separately. So this is the example for zero work. Next, one more example also we can say. Whenever the body travel along the circular path. This is one example. Example one. Next, example two. When the body move along the circular path. Suppose at certain instant, whenever the body is here, its velocity is along tangential direction. Along which direction velocity is there? Along that direction only displacement is also there. That's why at that instant, the displacement is also in the same direction. But whenever the body travels along the circular path, the centripetal force or normal force acts on the body towards center. No? That is equal to mv square by radius of the circular path r. The radius of circle path is say R. Okay, now what is the work done by centripetal force on the body? W is equal to centripetal force, WC is equal to, here you see, general formula is Fs cos theta. Work done by centripetal force is called F means centripetal force. F means Fc. Okay. Mv square by R into displacement. In a small interval of time, suppose the displacement is say S into cos. Angle between displacement and centripetal force, that is 90. That's why cos 90. It is zero, no? Therefore, work done by centripetal force on the body moving along the circular path is zero. So this is also the example for zero work done. It is also example for zero work done. If anything without kind of in chat, somebody else asked me question. In anything without contact of anything, then it is zero. In contact, body also can be zero. In case of a body without contact with the floor, the air resistance may be there. No, while moving in space, air resistance may be there. When air resistance is there, definitely some work is done against the air resistance or friction due to air. That is also called as the viscous drag. Some work is done. Okay, suppose if gravity free space, air is also not there. In such case, okay, the body travels with constant velocity. Even whatever the number of forces acts on a body, even then, if the body travels with constant velocity, in such case, net work done by all the forces on a body is equal to zero. Okay. Yeah, rowing boat also. In case of rowing boat also, between the water and the boat, there is some friction due to liquid. That is called viscous force. Against the viscous force, by means of engine of the boat, it pushes the boat in forward direction. That's why work is done against the viscous force. Because of that only, it will travel in forward direction. Okay, Green Ninja, right? Now next, positive work, zero work are completed. Next, negative work. Third one, negative work. Third one, negative work. Negative work. Here, negative work means whenever theta is greater than 90, okay, less than or equal to 180. Theta is greater than 90 or less than or equal to 180. In such case, work done is equal to Fs cos theta, no? So for all values of this one, definitely cos theta value is negative, no? 90, theta greater than 90. That means definitely theta value greater than 90 means it is not equal to 90. Greater than 90 means definitely cos value is negative, no? Because greater than 90 means this function lies in second quadrant. In second quadrant, cosine function negative, no? That's why for this condition, definitely if you substitute that angle here, definitely you'll get cos value negative. That's why work done is negative. Okay. So for all obtuse angles, theta is obtuse. That means it is just like this. Greater than 90, less than 180. In such case, theta obtuse. In such case, negative. Even cos theta value is 180 degree also, you'll get negative. Okay. So in this case, when theta is equal to 180 degree, then work done is equal to Fs cos 180. Therefore, W is equal to minus Fs. No, it is the formula here. This is the way of doing the negative work. You'll get definitely negative work. Units all are same. Okay. So this is called negative work. Already I said one example just now. Here, when a body is projected vertically upwards with certain velocity, after some time, it has displacement upwards is equal to S, or that is equal to H. Then weight of the body is equal to always acting vertically downwards direction. Then in this case, what is the work done by gravity, Wg? Work done by gravity is equal to general formula is Fs cos theta. Here, whenever the body is projected vertically upwards, the force acts on the body is equal to gravitational force only. No other force are there. Air friction is also not there. In this case, whenever the body is thrown vertically upwards, in such case, the force acts on the body vertically downwards is equal to, that is the weight of the body. Okay, displacement of the body after some time is H. Then in this case, due to this displacement, what is the work done by gravity? So this is equal to F means weight mg. S means H into cos. Here angle between displacement and weight, that is 180, no? So theta is equal to 180 degree here. So 180 you write. Then cos 180 minus 1. That's why you'll get minus mgh, no? Then if you get the work done like this, then we can say negative work is done. the therefore the negative work is equal to, when you write negative work again you should not mention minus sign. If you say simply work done means work done by gravity means minus mgh, negative work done by gravity is equal to mgh you have to write, because negative work done itself represents. That's why you should not write again minus. Okay, this is the exam formula for this. In this way we can find the negative work. It is the example. Okay, in this way there are three types of work done. There are three types of work done. Okay, why do not we take fs sin theta in vertically upwards? Okay, Raja Abhishek, in fs sin theta or cos theta we are writing? Fs sin. Raja Abhishek, I will meet off you. Talk with me. Raja Abhishek, hello. Okay, sir. Abhishek, Raja Abhishek, you speak with me. Yes, what sir. Is your doubts?
There we took upward direction for force and even displacement also.
Force is not in upward direction, just we projected upwards and we released it in case of vertically projected body. Here it is example for vertically projected body.
Okay, sir.
Vertically projected body, just we thrown upwards and we released it. We did not apply the force on a body continuously along vertical direction.
Okay, sir.
Okay, in that case weight is acting downwards and displacement of the body is along vertical direction. In that case angle between displacement and weight is equal to 180, no, because both are in opposite direction.
Yes, sir.
That's in this case fs cos 180. F means force acts on the body's weight only, into displacement h into theta, angle between these two 180. Therefore you will get minus 1 here, so minus mgh. That's why work done on the body which is thrown vertically upwards by the gravity is negative work done. Okay.
Okay.
Right now. Right. Here, these are the different cases and different types of work done. Okay. Now we have to discuss the different cases in which how we can calculate the work done. So some note points. These note points are very, very important to us. Different examples we have to discuss. Whether the work done is positive, negative, whatever it may be, we have to calculate the work done. Okay, note points. Here, in case first note point. Simple pendulum. Simple pendulum. Suppose by means of a light string, that means the mass of the string is negligible, a sphere having some mass is suspended from the point of suspension O. Okay, by applying some horizontal force in this direction, it is pulled through certain angle. Theta with the vertical, like this. The mass of the string is negligible. Okay, here whenever the bob of the pendulum, sphere attached to the string in the pendulum is called bob of the pendulum. So this is the bob of the pendulum. Okay, whenever the bob is pulled with a constant force F along horizontal direction, then the bob has displaced through an angle theta with the vertical, and it is under equilibrium at this case. Now what are the forces acts on the bob under equilibrium? One, weight of the bob acts vertically downwards direction, applied force is along horizontal direction, tension the string is in this direction. Okay, now in this case tell me here, what is the work done by applied force? Work done by applied force on a body WF is equal to how much, and work done by gravity is how much? We have to discuss this. And work done by tension also, what is the work done by tension? we have to discuss. Okay, now we see work done by applied force is equal to, here always on the bob of the pendulum horizontal force is applied like this, horizontal force is applied continuously like this. So along the direction here, as the force is always towards along horizontal direction, then along the horizontal force direction, what is the displacement of the bob of the pendulum? Because mass of the string is negligible, even it is displaced, no work is done on the string because mass is negligible. Light string, light inextensible string, I said. Okay, then to displace the bob along horizontal direction through angle theta with the vertical by the applied horizontal force, what is the work done? That is equal to force F into displacement of the bob of the pendulum along horizontal direction. Here displacement of the bob along the direction of the applied horizontal force means initially the bob is here. Whenever it displaces through an angle theta, it comes to this position. So what is the horizontal distance traveled along the direction of applied force means this one, that is say x. So F into x, this is the, because horizontal force is in this direction, whereas the displacement of the bob along horizontal direction is also in the same direction. That's why Fx cos 0, because displacement along horizontal direction is in this direction, applied force also in the same direction. That's why cos 0, 1. Therefore F into x. What about F into, what about x? Here length of the pendulum is say L. Length of the pendulum is say L. Then what is this value? From the diagram you take sine theta. Sine theta is equal to, in this right angle triangle, x by hypotenuse means L. Or x is equal to L sine theta, no? That's why L sine theta. This is the work done by applied force. In the same time, what is the work done by gravity? Work done by gravity is equal to, you see, here whenever the bob is here, the gravitational force mg acts vertically downwards direction. Whenever it displaces through angle theta, the bob comes to this position. That means along the direction of applied gravity, along the direction of gravity means along vertical direction. What is the displacement of the bob? That displacement of the bob is say h. You see, here, whenever the bob displaces from this position to this position, then the bob displaces vertically upwards, initially at this position, finally at this position. So through what height the bob displaces means h. That is opposite to the direction of the gravity, no? That's why work done by gravity means force, gravitational force mg into displacement s into cos theta, general formula. So gravitational force mg into displacement. Here you see, whenever the bob travels from this position to this position, then along the direction of gravity, the displacement of the bob is h. Because from this position to this position, along vertical, what is the displacement means h. Okay, and force is equal to weight only, mg into cos. What about angle between displacement along vertical direction and gravitational force mg? Mg is downwards direction, whereas displacement is in upward direction. That's why 180, no? Cos 180. That is equal to cos 180 minus 1, so minus mg into h. But h is not given, just we are given theta. So we have to find theta, h value, in terms of theta. So from the diagram, you take cos theta. Cos theta is equal to, what about this value? L cos theta, no? Sorry. This value is how much? L cos theta, isn't it? Because in this right angle triangle, cos theta is equal to, adjacent means this value. This is a y. Okay. So adjacent y by hypotenuse. So y is equal to L cos theta, no? Already I write y is equal to L cos theta. Okay. Now, whenever the bob comes from this position to this position, what about h value? Initially, whenever the bob is here, this is equal to length of the pendulum. That is equal to length of the string. That means L. This length is L, no? This length is L. Okay, L. Here, this value is equal to L cos theta. So, what is H value? Whenever the bar comes to this position, it displaces through a distance H in upward direction. That is equal to H. From the diagram, it is L. It is L cos theta. So, this H is equal to how much? From the diagram, H is equal to L minus Y. This, from this L, you subtract Y. That is equal to H. Therefore, L minus Y means L cos theta. Therefore, L of 1 minus cos theta. This is the displacement along vertical direction. Or this is the height up to which the body rises whenever the pendulum displaces through an angle theta. Therefore, work done by gravity, Wg is equal to minus mg into H, no? So, minus mg into H means L of 1 minus cos theta. This is the work done by gravity. That means work done by gravity is negative. work done by gravity is negative. Okay. Here, whenever the bob is here, initially, whenever there is no displacement in the bob, the gravitational force mg acts vertically downwards direction. Of course, by applied force here, the bob is displaced through an angle theta with vertical. Whenever the bob is here, the gravitational force mg acts vertically downwards direction. Okay, initially bob is here, but after whenever it has displaced through an angle theta, the bob comes to this position. So along vertical, what is the displacement of the bob? Initially the bob is here. Whenever it displaces through angle theta, the bob comes to this horizontal position. So through what vertical distance it travel means that is equal to h, no? That the displacement of the bob along vertical direction is along the gravitational force. That's why work done by gravity means weight m. Here general formula is this one: f, fs cos theta. F means mg into s means along vertical direction. The displacement is equal to h, no? So displacement is equal to h into cos. Displacement is upwards direction, whereas gravity is in downwards direction. That means against the gravity, the body displaces through a distance equal to h along vertical direction. That's why angle between displacement and weight, that is 180. So minus mgh. Okay. Venkatesh, are you followed this one? Venkatesh, here displacement of the bob is along vertical direction, whereas gravitational force is in downwards direction. So what is the angle between displacement and gravity? Displacement is along vertical direction and gravity is in downwards direction. Here you see, here the displacement of the bob whenever the pendulum displaces through angle theta along vertical direction is equal to h, because whenever the simple pendulum displaces through the angle theta, then bob comes to this position. At the time along vertical direction, what is the distance traveled means h only, no? Whereas the gravity always acts vertically downwards direction. That means against the gravity, the bob of the pendulum displaces through a distance h in upward direction. That's why work done is so much. F means mg, displacement h into cos, angle between these two, displacement and gravitational force is equal to 180, no? That's why work done is equal to minus mgh. Okay. What about cos theta? What I want to explain? Vinod Kumar, what you asked me, explain. I will mute off you. You speak with me. Okay.
Sir, from cos, this side, sir, cos theta is equals to y by l.
In this right angle triangle, you see, this is a right angle triangle, no? In this right angle triangle, cos theta is equal to this distance. That is why I said.
Yes, sir.
Why? Cos theta is equal to y by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse, it is the length of the string only, no? Length of the pendulum only, no?
Yes, sir.
Because this length is L. So it comes to this position. So length is equal to L itself. That's why cos theta is equal to y by L. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, so this is one example. Next, second one. Suppose there is a hanging rope. There is a hanging uniform rope. Uniform rope. The mass of the uniform rope is m and length is l, say. Length is l. Mass is m. Okay, now here there is a hole. Through that hole the rope is hanging. Then what is the amount of work to be done by the applied force? What is the amount of work to be done by the applied force to pull this hanging rope onto the table? Here suppose this is the table. So we have to pull the hanging rope onto the table. What is the work to be done? That is the case. Okay. In this case, you see, here the mass of the rope is not point mass, because the mass of the rope is extended from this end to this end. Mass of the rope is extended from this end to this end. here previously in case of sphere, the string is having negligible mass. Only the bob of the pendulum only having mass. That means this, whenever compared with this length of the pendulum, the size of the bob is very less. That's why it can be treated as a point mass. So whenever this point mass displaces from this position to this position, what is the work done by the applied force? What is the work done by the weight? And what is the work done by tension here? Work done by tension in this case. Work done by tension. Wt is equal to how much in this case? You see, always the displacement is along the arc. That means along tangential direction. Whereas tension is in this direction. Both are 90, no? That's why work done by tension is equal to T into displacement S into cos 90. That is equal to zero. Therefore, work done by tension is equal to zero in this case. Work done by tension in this case is zero. Okay, now here, or you take one more here in this way, you take like this. Suppose it is the table, chain on table. Here, from the edge of the table, uniform chain is hanging like this. An uniform chain is hanging. A uniform chain having length L, mass M, that is hanging. From the edge of the table, a uniform chain having mass M, length is L, that is hanging from the edge of the table. Now, what is the work to be done to pull it onto the table? What is the work to be done to pull the entire chain onto the table? So what is the minimum amount of work to be done to pull the chain onto the table? That is the question. Minimum work to be done. Minimum work done to pull the hanging chain onto the table. Hanging chain onto the table. Comma W is equal to how much? It's very, very important. Previously in mains, they asked the question also. Not MLG. We have to see. Here, the chain is not the point mass, no? Because the mass of the chain is extended from one edge to other edge. That's why it is not the point object. It is an extended object. If the mass of any body is extended up to certain length, then we can say that is an extended object. So chain is the best example for an extended object. Okay, in this case, how we can calculate? Suppose if it is the point mass, suppose the chain is the point mass, then what is the work to be done to pull the chain onto the table? Means mg into this displacement h, that gives the work done directly. But the chain is having mass extend from one end to other end. That means it is an extended object. In this case, to calculate the work done, suppose you consider the small element here. Of course, simple method is also there. I will explain. Suppose you consider the small element having length dy. Okay, from the edge of the table, this element considered is at a distance, say y. Mass of the element is, say, dm. Mass of the element is dm. How we can find the mass of the element? Mass of the element dm is equal to, you see, the total length of the chain is L and mass of the chain is m. Then what is the mass per unit length? M by L, no? For this much length of the chain, mass is m. Then what is the mass per unit length? Means m by L. It is the mass per unit length. That is called linear mass density. So m by L is called linear mass density. Linear mass density. Okay, then mass of this element considered is equal to linear mass density, means m by L. For unit length, if it is the mass, for this much length of the element, what is the mass? Means into dy. This is the mass of the element considered. It is the mass of the element considered. Here, as this is the element, these dimensions are negligible. That's why this element can be treated as a point mass. Then to displace this element from this position onto the table, through what distance it has to be displaced? to displace this element onto the table, what is the work to be done? We have to calculate first. So in order to move this element onto the table, up to what distance the element is to be displaced upwards, that means y. Here definitely gravity pulls the chain downwards directionally, it cannot pushes the chain upwards. So by applying some force, say df, okay, we have to pull the chain onto the table, we have to pull the element of the chain onto the table. So work done to pull the element onto the tables, small amount of work to be done on the element to pull it onto the table is equal to minimum force required, to pull the element onto the table, df, into displacement of the chain element. To pull this element onto the table, the displacement of the element must be equal to y only, no? Because it is at a distance y, that's why into y, into cos. Force applied on the element upwards is upwards, and displacement also upwards, that's why cos theta means zero. Therefore dfi, what is df here? You see, to pull the element in upward direction, what is the minimum force to be applied? The weight of the element dm into g acts downwards direction, no? At least we have to pull this element upwards, we have to apply at least the force on the element equal to its weight. That's why the minimum force to be applied on the element to pull upwards is equal to weight of the element only. Weight of the element means mass of the element into acceleration due to gravity. Here this applied force upwards is equal to weight. It is not the work done by the work done on the element while moving upwards by the gravity. It is the work done by applied force only. That applied force is equal to dmg, no? Because they asked the minimum work to be done. Minimum work to be done to pull the chain onto the table means minimum force to be applied on the element in upward direction is equal to weight of the element into y into cos 0 1. What is the mass of the element? Mass of the element is m by l, okay, into dy into z into y. So mz by l into y dy. This is the amount of work to be done to pull the element onto the table. Here this type of elements can be imagined from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to l, no? This type of elements can be imagined from this end to this end. For each and every element, you find the work done to pull the each and every element onto the table, you find the work done and you add them. That gives the total work done in pulling the chain onto the table. In this way, we can imagine infinite number of such elements in the length from a y is equal to 0 to y is equal to l. For all infinite elements, it is not possible to find the work done. That's why for one element, what is the amount of work done to pull the to bring the element onto the table, you find the work done, and you integrate between the limits from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to l. Because this type of elements can be imagined from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to l. That's why between y is equal to 0 to l, you integrate. Okay, therefore total work done is equal to integral dw between the limits y is equal to 0 to y is equal to l. This is equal to dw means mz by l into y dy, limits y is equal to 0 to l. Okay, therefore mz by l is constant, you write outside. Integral y dy, integral y dy means y square by 2, no? Limits 0 to l. This is equal to mz by l into, when you substitute upper limit, l square by 2 you will get, and when you substitute lower limit, y is equal to 0, that's why you'll get 0. So l square cancel. Okay, therefore work done, w, work done by the applied force in pulling the hanging chain onto the table is equal to mz l by 2. This is the formula for work done to pull the hanging chain onto the table. Hanging chain, hanging rope, everyone onto the table. Okay, here this is one method, it is the integration method. The simple method is center of mass concept method is there. So by using that method also we can calculate. Okay, now by another method we have to do. Second method, it is the first method, method 1, method 2. Okay, here one chain is hanging like this. here actually, suppose you see, this is a uniform rod. Uniform rod means mass per unit length of the rod remains same at every place. Okay, then that is called uniform rod. In case of uniform rod, suppose when you keep the rod over the tip of the nail, at what position when the nail is kept, the rod is under equilibrium, it will not fall either this direction or this direction. The rod will should not be tilted in any direction. At what position we have to keep the nail? Come on, anybody else respond? Exactly at the midpoint, because it is a uniform rod. That's why exactly at the midpoint, when you keep the nail, tip of the nail, then it will be under equilibrium so that it does not tilt either in this direction or in this direction. That is called the center of mass. Okay, center of the rod means midpoint of the rod. So that is called the center of mass of the rod. That means here exactly when you balance this this pen, marker pen, over the tip of the nail like this, okay, then the total mass of this pen concentrate exactly at this point only, you know, that point relative to the body where the total mass is supposed to be concentrated, because the mass is not concentrated exactly at this point. The mass is extended from this end to this end, but when it is balanced over the tip of the nail, then the total mass exists at this point. That's why the total mass is supposed to be concentrated at certain point in the body. That point is called center of mass. At the center of mass, whatever the shape of the body, the total mass can be imagined at the center of mass. Of course, we are having different separate chapter, center of mass chapter is there. At that time, I will discuss in detail. In different cases also, we will discuss. But now, just you are having an idea. You should have some idea. That's why I said this example. Okay, the point relative to the body, or the point at which the total mass of the body supposed to be concentrated. Actually, it is not concentrated exactly at midpoint, but seems to be concentrated or supposed to be concentrated. That's why such point is called the center of mass. Okay. In case of any uniform body, the center of mass lies exactly at the geometric center. In case of uniform rope, the center of mass lies exactly at the midpoint, means here. This total length is L, no? Total length is L. So center of mass lies exactly at the midpoint. So here, y is equal to distance of the center of mass from the edge of the table is equal to L by 2, no? Okay, center of mass is at a distance L by 2 from the edge of the table. So when you consider the center of mass here, the total mass of the hanging part, hanging chain, must be can be imagined at the center of mass. So here the total mass of the hanging chain can be imagined at the center of mass at this point. Okay, now you forget the entire chain, just at the center of mass, what the total mass of the chain can be imagined here. So that at this point the mass is M. So to pull this center of mass onto the table, whatever the work done, that is the work done in pulling the total hanging chain onto the table. Okay, therefore work done is equal to work done to pull the center of mass onto the table means at the center of mass total mass is there. So what is the force to be applied on the center of mass in upward direction? That force to be applied on the center of mass in upward direction is equal to at the center of mass total mass can be imagined. That's why weight mg acts downwards direction. To pull the center of mass upwards, we have to apply at least the force equal to weight at the center of mass. Okay. Therefore, Fs cos theta, from this formula, F means mg, S means what is the displacement of center of mass, that is equal to L by 2 into cos. Force is in this direction, displacement also in the same direction. That's why theta is equal to 0. Therefore, implies work done is equal to mg into L by 2. This is the formula for work done to pull the hanging chain onto the table. I think we got the same formula, no? Here and here, by this method also we got same formula. Which method is best? It is easy method, simple method. We can follow like this. Okay? But in some cases, If it is not uniform chain, in that case, how the mass of the chain varies with the distance from the one edge, that will be mentioned. In such case, we must do by integration method only. If it is uniform rope or uniform chain, in that case, this center mass concept is okay. Otherwise, if it is the non-uniform chain, that means along the length of the chain, if the mass gradually increases, in such case, that is a non-uniform chain. In that case, definitely the integration method is suitable. This type of problem may be asked in advance. It is in case of mains, they may ask. Okay, that's why I said the both methods. These are very, very important. Okay, next. one more example, one more note point. Is it note 1 or note 2? It is note 1 only, no? Next, note 2. So, second note point. Suppose it is the table kept on the floor. Okay, here there is a uniform rope having mass, uniform chain or rope having mass m and length l. It is kept on the table so that one end of length of the chain is hanging from the edge of the table. Here the length of the chain hanging small l is equal to one end of length of the chain. This is hanging from the edge of the table. Okay, now the work to be done to pull the hanging part onto the table. Work to be done to pull hanging part onto the table. Hanging part onto the table. Onto the table. Comma. W is equal to question mark. That is the case. Okay. Here, in case of hanging part, central mass lies exactly at the midpoint now. Central mass lies exactly at the midpoint. To displace the here, to displace the central mass in upward onto the table, what is the displacement? Y. That Y is equal to L by 2, no? Because the total length of the hanging part is small L. Of course, that is equal to L by N. Central mass lies exactly at the midpoint because it is the uniform rope. That's why midpoint. Therefore, to pull this central mass onto the table, displacement of the central mass is equal to, say, Y. That is equal to half of the length of the hanging part, no? That means L by 2, which is equal to small L means L by N by 2. That means L by 2N. This is the displacement of the central mass onto the table. Okay, now work done W is equal to, what is the mass of the central mass here? Mass of the mass at the central mass is equal to, say, M. Okay, here mass at the central mass means mass of the hanging part lies exactly at the central mass. So what is the mass of the hanging part? And mass of the entire chain is M, length is L. Then what is the mass per unit length? M by L. If it is the mass per unit length, then what is the mass of this hanging part? That means into small l, no? Small l means L by N. Therefore, LL cancel. So, M by small n. It is the mass of the hanging part. That mass of the hanging part lies exactly at the central mass. That's why at the central mass, mass is M by N. Mass is equal to M by N. Okay, now to pull this central mass onto the table, what is the work done? That means the force to be applied at the central mass to pull upwards is equal to its weight. That is equal to small m into g. Okay. Applied force is equal to mg into displacement y. Now you substitute the data. M means m by n into g into y means l by 2n. Therefore, work done to pull the hanging part onto the table is equal to mgl by 2n square. This is the formula for work to be done to pull the hanging part onto the table. Sometimes you will be given small l only. Length of the hanging part is small l only. In that case, what is the work to be done to pull the hanging part onto the table means m by capital L, mass of the hanging part m by capital L into length of the hanging part small l, m by capital L into small l into z into y. Y means the central mass of the hanging part is at a distance L by small L by 2. So small L by 2 upwards. That's why Y is called small L by 2. You write. Simplify them, you will get answer. So this is the second case. Okay, next. Next. Note 3. Note 3. Suppose there is a uniform rod. There is a uniform rod like this. It is suspended at its one end. The uniform rod having mass m length L. The uniform rod of mass M, length L, that is suspended from the one end by means of a hinge. By means of a hinge, it is suspended. As it is suspended by means of hinge, it can be turned like this. In vertical plane, it can be turned like this. Okay, now by applying some force on the rod at the lower end, it is displaced so that it makes an angle theta with the vertical. It is displaced through an angle theta with the vertical. Then what is the work done by applied force on the rod? What is the work done by applied force on the rod? Or what is the work done by gravity in this case? Here, work done by gravity, they asked. Work done by gravity. Wg is equal to question mark. Work done by gravity is equal to how much? Okay. Note 4. Okay. Note 4. Yeah, note 4. Whatever it may be. So work done by gravity is how much? You see, the center mass of the rod is exactly at the midpoint now because it is a uniform rod. It is a uniform rod. In case of uniform rod, center mass lies exactly at the midpoint of the rod means here. Here, the total mass of the rod, M, can be imagined at this point. When it is turned through an angle theta, then exactly center mass comes to this position. The center mass of the rod means midpoint here. That is here. So initially center mass is here, center mass, and finally whenever the rod is turned through angle theta, center mass comes to this position. So through what distance center mass rises? Y is equal to question mark. That is the case. Here, whatever this length, here it is the center mass means it is a midpoint. That's why this length is equal to half of the length of the rod now, L by 2. What about this length? This is a H, not Y. This is a H. Because the height up to center mass rises, that is say H. You say this is Y. So, whenever the rod is turned through an angle theta, what is the distance of center mass? Okay, what is the, here, you see, what is the vertical distance of center mass from the hinge? That is say Y. Okay, from the diagram, Y is equal to means, you take cos theta. Cos theta is equal to edge in this right angle triangle. Cos theta is equal to y by this distance. Hypotenuse means this one. Because in this right angle triangle, we have considered the cos theta. So that's why this is equal to how much? This total length is L. Center mass lies exactly at midpoint. That's why this length is equal to L by 2, no? L by 2. That's why y by L by 2 implies y is equal to L by 2 into cos theta. Okay, this is the y value. Therefore, displacement of the center mass along vertically upward direction, h is equal to how much? From this L by 2, you subtract Y. L by 2 minus Y. That is called L by 2 minus Y means L by 2 cos theta. Therefore, H is equal to, you take L by 2 common, 1 minus cos theta. 1 minus cos theta. This is the height up to which the center mass rises. Therefore, work done by gravity is equal to, general formula is Fs cos theta. Okay, at the center mass, weight mg. Weight of the rod mg acts downwards direction into displacement of the center mass, that is equal to h. Vertical displacement of the center mass is h, you know, into cos. Here, what is the angle up to which center mass displaces along vertical? Here theta means this, it is this theta here is not this one. Here weight mg acts vertically downwards. Here you say theta naught. Here weight mg acts downwards direction, displacement of center mass upward direction. Angle between weight and displacement of center mass is 180. That's why theta naught is 180 here, since theta naught is equal to 180. So therefore, mg into h means this one, L by 2 into 1 minus cos theta into cos 180 minus 1. Therefore, minus mg L by 2 into 1 minus cos theta. This is the work done by gravity. It is the work done by gravity. Our work done by applied force is how much? That means positive we have to take. Because to pull the rod in upward direction like this, work is done by the applied force must be positive. Then only it displaces like that. So what is the work done by applied force means plus we have to take. Work done by gravity means minus we have to take. Work done by applied force. W is equal to same formula, but positive. Mz L by 2 into 1 minus cos theta. Okay, next. Fifth note point. Fifth note point, suppose initially the rod is kept on the horizontal floor. The rod is kept on the horizontal floor. Okay. One end of here, mass of the rod is exactly center mass lies here. Mass of the rod is M. And weight Mz acts vertically downwards direction. The length of the rod is equal to capital L. That is given. By held one end here without slipping, the rod is turned through an angle theta. The rod is turned through an angle theta like this. The rod is turned through an angle theta about one edge. About one end or one edge. The rod is turned through an angle theta. Then what is the work done by external force? Or what is the work done by gravity? Initially, whenever the rod is on horizontal surface, center mass is here. Center mass is CM. CM means center of mass. Whenever the rod comes to this position, center mass lies exactly at the midpoint, means here, no? That means center mass displaces through a distance equal to h. Okay? Now, in this case, what is the work done by gravity? Work done by gravity is equal to Wz, that is equal to, here exactly at the center mass, total mass can be imagined, no? That's why general formula is Fs cos theta. F means at the center mass, total weight Mz acts into displacement of center mass is H. Because initially center mass is here, whenever the rod is turned through angle theta, that is center mass displaces through a height H along vertical direction. Weight Mz acts downwards direction and displacement upward direction into cos 180. Therefore, Mz, what about H value here? From the diagram, you see this length is equal to L by 2, no? We need H value. Therefore, you take sine theta. Sin theta is equal to, in this right angle triangle, sin theta is equal to h by L by 2. Or h is equal to L by 2 sin theta. No? You substitute here. Mz into h means, of course, L by 2 sin theta. Cos 180 minus 1. Therefore, minus Mz L by 2 sin theta. This is the work done by gravity. So, in this case, what is the work done by external force? They may ask. Work done by external force. Work done by external force. Whatever the work done by body, the work done by external force is also same. That is equal to plus this one. So Mz L by 2 sin theta. This is the work done by external force to displace the rod through an angle theta from horizontal. Okay. Next. Next, one more important problem concept that is important for mains. So, to lift the bucket from the well, what is the work to be done? To lift the bucket with water. So, well hyphen bucket concept. Well hyphen bucket. Okay, here you see there is a well. There is a well. Water is there up to this surface, up to this point. Here it is the water. The depth of the well means from the top of the well up to the surface of the water, we can treat the depth of the well. So depth of the well is say small h. Depth of the well is small h. Okay, now here by means of a rope with the help of the bucket, the water is to be lifted. Okay, that's why, what is the minimum length of the rope we need to lift the water from the well with the help of the buckets? What is the minimum length of the rope, you tell me? Equal to h. Whatever the depth of the well, that amount of length of the rope is required to lift the water from the well with the help of the bucket. That's why here the length of the rope is equal to depth of the well. Okay, here a bucket is there. Here a bucket is there. Mass of the bucket with water is say capital M. Mass of the rope, here mass is also not negligible mass. It is having some mass M say. Okay, what is the work to be done to lift the water with bucket in upward direction? That is say W. So what is the amount of work to be done by external force to lift the bucket with water to the top of the well? That is the question. Okay, here to lift, first of all, to lift the water with the help of the bucket, we have to pull the rope onto the well, top of the well now. We have to pull the rope to the top of the well now. So here work to be done to pull the rope, work to be done to pull the rope, plus work to be done to pull the buckets. There are two cases. This is equal to work to be done to lift the, to pull the rope onto the top of the well is equal to, here rope is the mass extended object, because mass is extended from this one to this one. That's why you consider the sandra mass. To pull the sandra mass onto the to the top of the well, whatever the work done, that is the work done to pull the entire rope onto the top of the well. That's why mass of the rope, at the sandra mass, the total mass of the rope M is there, weight mg into. To pull the sandra mass onto the top of the well, what is the distance to be raised? Distance to be raised, h dash is equal to h by 2 only, no? Because the length of the rope is h. That's why sandra mass lies exact at the midpoint. To pull the sandra mass onto the top, to the top of the well, what is the distance to be displaced means? That is equal to h by 2. That's why here h dash. Okay. Here, by applied force, what is the work done? They ask, not due to weight. That's why applied force must be equal to weight of the rope only. That's why applied force is equal to weight into displacement h dash. Plus, work done to lift the bucket onto the top of the well is equal to weight of the bucket mg into, to displace the bucket with water, m means mass of the bucket with water, onto the top of the well. Then what is the total displacement of the bucket? When compared with this length, the size of the bucket is negligible. That's why bucket can be treated as a confined mass. To displace this bucket to the top of the well, what is the distance to be displaced? The displacement of the bucket must be equal to depth of the well, no? That's why h. Therefore, mz into, what about h dash? What about h dash? Yeah. H dash is equal to h by 2, because sandra mass is to be lifted to a distance equal to h by 2, no? H by 2 plus mz into h. This is a work to be done by external agent or external force to lift the water onto the top of the well. That is the case. Okay. Suppose two ropes are there. To lift the bucket, two ropes are fixed. Then here into two we have to write, because for it is the work to be done to lift one rope. Work to be done to lift the, to pull the two ropes means into two we have to write. That is the case. Okay. H dash is equal to, you see, H dash is equal to, that means to pull the hanging rope, to pull the rope onto the top of the well, what is the work done means? In case of rope, it is the extended object, because the mass extended along its length uniformly. That's why sandra mass concept we have to consider. In case of hanging rope, sandra mass lies exactly at the midpoint, no? That's why to lift the sandra mass onto the top of the well, whatever the work done, that is the work done to lift the entire rope onto the top of the well, to the top of the well. That's why to lift the sandra mass to the top of the well, the displacement is equal to half of the length of the rope. Length of the rope is equal to h. Half of the length of the rope is h by 2. That is the displacement of the sandra mass. H dash is equal to L by 2. Okay. Mass of the bucket is capital M, I wrote now in the diagram. Right. This is one more example. Next. Seventh one, suppose on the rough floor, on the rough floor, you see, here by means of certain, here one body is projected so that it has displaced to a distance, yes, in forward direction. At the same time, as it is in motion, then kinetic friction acts in backward direction. Weight mg acts downwards. Normal action acts upwards. Okay, now what is the work done by friction? What is the work done by friction on the block? whenever it has displaced through a distance equal to s. When the block displaces through a distance, yes, what is the work done by the friction? General formula is Fs cos theta. F means frictional force, that is equal to Fk into displacement S into cos. Here displacement in this direction, friction is in opposite direction. That's why angle between kinetic friction and displacement is 180, no? Cos 180. Therefore, cos 180 minus 1. So minus Fk into S. Minus Fk means mu into, here coefficient of friction between the block and the floor is say mu. Mu into normal reaction into S. That is equal to minus mu into normal reaction means here along vertical direction, the weight acts downwards direction and the normal reaction acts upward direction. Even then, as there is no motion along vertical direction, normal reaction is equal to weight itself, no? Mg into displacement, yes. It is the work done by friction. In this case, what is the work done by gravity? Tell me, what is the work done by gravity in this case? Displacement in this direction, gravity in this direction. That's why Fs cos theta means, from this Fs cos theta, F means weight into displacement means S into cos. Angle between displacement and weight, that is 90. Cos 90. Zero, no? That's why work done by gravity is equal to zero. Work done by normal reaction in this case is equal to, formula same. F means normal reaction into S into cos. Angle between normal reaction and displacement is 90. So cos 90, 0. Therefore, work done by normal reaction is also equal to 0 in this case. This is another example. Okay, next. Eighth one. Suppose there is a Atwood machine. Here it is a light frictionless pulley. To the one end of the string, light string, a block of mass M1 is fixed. And the string is passed over the light frictionless pulley. And at the other end of the light and extensible string, a block of mass M2 is kept. A block of mass M2 is kept. Here, M2 greater than M1. When you release the two blocks, in which direction the blocks will move? What is your doubt? Okay. Karthi, the block M2 will move downwards because M2 is greater now. M2 will move down and M1 will rise up. Okay. Suppose the acceleration with which the block comes down is say A. And the acceleration of this block also same because it is the inextensible string. With what acceleration this block M2 comes down? With the same acceleration it rises up. I think before closing the classes, before your vacation, I said this concept. Okay. Here with what acceleration the block M2 comes down? With the same acceleration the block M1 will rise up. What is that acceleration? Anybody else having idea about acceleration? Yeah, M moves up and M2 move downwards. What is the formula for acceleration? Okay. You see, in case of a block of mass M2, the weight M2z acts downwards direction. Because of that, is it falls freely? No. At the same time, the string pulls the block in upward direction with certain force, that is called tension. Okay. Similarly, here also, weight M1 falling body. As it is connected to the string here, the string pulls the block in upward direction. With certain force, that is called tension. But here it is totally light inextensible string, light string. That's why whatever the tension here, the tension here is also same. That's why T. The same tension, of course, tension is always acting away from the body. Tension acts on the block always away from the block means here. Tension the string acts away from the block.
tension the string at this point acts away from the pulley, that means downwards. Here also downwards. Okay, now whenever you release them, as the block comes down, M2 comes down, this weight greater than tension. That's why net force acts on this block is M2Z minus T. That is equal to
into acceleration A. Okay. Next, for this one, as M1Z acts downwards and T upwards, even then as the block M1 moves upwards, T is greater than M1Z. That's why T minus M1Z is equal to M1 into A. Now you add these two, then tension will be cancelled. Then M2Z minus M1Z, you take MG common, M2 minus M1 into Z is equal to, you add these two, and A you take common, M2 plus M1 into A. Therefore, acceleration of the block, each block is equal to M2 minus M1 into Z by M2 plus M1. This is the formula for M2 plus M1. This is the formula for acceleration of each block. But one block moves upwards, another block moves downwards with the same acceleration. Both blocks are having same acceleration. Yeah, that is only. Right. Next, what about the tension in the string? Because to find the work done, we need the tension also. What is the tension in the string? To find the tension here, you see, in this, you divide the two equations. Then A will be cancelled and T will, you will get. Or in any one of the equations, you substitute A value and you simplify them. You will get tension. Suppose this is equation 1, this is a equation 2. From 1, M2Z minus T is equal to M2 into A. M2Z minus T is equal to M2 into A means M2 minus M1 by M2 plus M1 into Z. Or T is equal to M2Z, T you write on right side and you bring this right term to left. M2Z minus M2 into M2 minus M1 by M2 plus M1 into Z. So you take LCM. You take G common and you take LCM. Then M2 plus M1 is LCM. Okay. M2 into M2 plus M1 minus M2 into M2 minus M1. Okay. This is equal to, you see, M2 into M2, M2 square. Minus M2 into M2, M2 square. Minus M2 square plus M2 square cancel. M2, M1, minus or minus plus M2 into M1. That means M1, M2, M1 plus M2, M1. That means 2 M1, M2. So 2 M1, M2 by M2 plus M1 into G is there. G. This is the tension in the string. Already derived. Okay, now, in this case, suppose in a given time interval, the block S1 displaces through a distance, say S. S1 is equal to S. Of course, S1 is upwards. But here, whatever the displacement of this block in upward direction, it has the same displacement in downwards direction. That's why displacement of block S2, that is also equal to S in downwards direction. Okay, now, what is the work done by for M1? What is the work done by gravity? You see, weight in downwards direction, displacement is in upward direction. That's why work done by gravity is negative, no? So minus M1Z into S. Because when the block is displaced upward direction, work done by gravity is called minus MGH, no? As the displacement upwards is S, that's why work done is equal to minus M1Z into S. Work done by tension is equal to, work done by tension in this case. You see, tension is in upward direction, displacement also in the same direction. That's why tension into displacement into cos 0. Because tension and displacement both are in the same direction. That's why theta is equal to 0. Therefore, TS. Work done by tension. T means this one. Of course, you substitute there. Then T into S. It is the work done by tension. It is the work done by gravity. Okay. Similarly, on for M2. What is the work done by gravity? Weight M2Z acts downwards direction, displacement also in the same direction. That's why work done by gravity is equal to weight into displacement in downwards direction. Yes, positive only. Because weight M2Z downwards and displacement also downwards. So in general formula, Fs cos theta. In that formula, F means M2Z, S means S only, cos angle between weight and displacement, 0, cos 0, 1. That's why you will get like this. Next, in this case, what is the work done by the tension on the block M2? You see, tension upwards and displacement downwards. That's why TS cos 180 means minus TS, no? TS cos 180. That means minus TS. So work done by tension on the block M2 is minus TS. Work done by tension on the block M1 is plus TS. Therefore, on the system, work done by tension on the system, work done by tension on the system, WT is equal to work done by, you see, work done by gravity on the first block is WT1. Work done by tension on the first block is WT1. On the second block, that is a WT2. Therefore, WT1 plus WT2. Therefore, total work done by tension on the system is equal to WT1 is TS, WT2 is minus TS. That is equal to zero, no? Therefore, net work done by tension on the system is equal to zero. Net work done by the tension on the system of two blocks is equal to zero. That is the case. Okay. Here, this is another case. Next. Ninth one. Just 5 minutes I will take. 40 is over. Just 5 minutes I will take. Because only few two cases are there. Extra two cases. If I complete them, then work done case will be over. No, next three, four cases are there. Okay, next class I will continue. Okay, thank you. Today I will send the assignment to you through WhatsApp group. You do those problems. Tomorrow we'll discuss some more points based on the work done, and we do some problems also. Thank you, Vananda. Okay, bye, Nana.